I always call us a punk band.
My question is, why have you waited 2 years, essentially, to put out the third single from an old album?
So the album changed everything for us, and this is on a super small scale, so take everything I say with a massive pinch of salt, a spoonful of salt. But it did change everything for us. On our first record, we were just 18, 19 year olds in a bedroom, driving our neighbours up the wall because we were recording albums and making a load of noise, and we were into lo-fi punk music. So, you know, we loved it, but we were just, some of us were students at the time, and it was just, you know, doing it for the love of doing it. And when we wrote Auslander and recorded it, it was still that, you know, we weren't making any money at all. We were losing money drastically because we were just, any money we made, we threw at the band, doing it because we loved it. And we went into recording Auslander with that mindset. And in fact, there is a, it's not really a documentary, but 20 minute odd video of us recording Auslander online, so you can find it if you type it in. And I think you can see that, you know, we went up to, Sol's mum lives in Scotland, and her next door neighbour is like 3 miles down the road. Like, there's no one around. And she was so kind enough to be like, yeah, you can record your next album, you know, in my house. And I was like, brilliant. So we went up there and we treated it like it was the best time of our lives. Honestly, it was, you know, a beautiful experience. And we stayed up there and recorded the album, or most of the album. And we didn't really think anything of it. So then we released P45. Before the album came out, and all of a sudden people started paying attention to it a lot more, paying attention to the band. And within London's music scene, it's quite a difficult music scene to get into. Once you're in it, it can be quite good, but there's so many bands trying to do the same thing. But we released P45 and people in that scene started paying attention a little bit to Brain Ape. And so by the time we released Auslander, we started selling CDs, which was something we never ever thought we'd do. You know, our first record, I think the lifespan of our first record, we printed 30 CDs and they sold out within like 3 years. You know, so to have a record that you put out and people are actually talking about it and people are writing, and again, don't forget the salt, but people are writing about it, writing reviews and articles, and you're going to a show, not your own show, completely unrelated, and someone in the audience who you vaguely maybe know from having seen them around has heard your record and digs it. Totally weird to us. So then we released Graphomania the year after the album came out as the next single, and that did even better for us. And then by that point we'd started going over to Europe to play shows, and it started getting a little bit bigger, and then we had t-shirts and all that sort of thing. And since then, Brain Ape has become a thing that runs itself. You know, it's taken up all of my life. And there's some talk about maybe doing this professionally if we can, and it's completely different world. It's morphed into something so drastically different. So the reason we're putting out a third single from this album 18 months after the last single is because that journey has changed us so much, and we really like to sort of bookend that experience. A couple of years ago, Sol went off on a year of just like living abroad, to find himself, I'm sure. But at the time, Brain Ape, we'd just done our first album. I think he went the year after that. And obviously that kind of put the band into question because he's off for a year. And I made a record with a mate of mine and sort of a side project thing, and that was fun. And then I produced my sister's first EP and that was fun. But I kind of ended up in a scenario where I guess I was at a crossroads and I didn't really know what direction I was going to take it, my life in. Excuse me, phone. I had no idea what direction I was going to take my life in. And then I found acting, completely haphazardly. and started doing that for a couple of years and basically didn't play music.
Are you still acting?
Not anymore, simply because I've got no time with Brainy. So again, Auslander changed. Before, when I was recording Auslander, I was still an actor, if sort of quote unquote. I just finished doing one of my favourite films I ever did, actually. And Soul had come back, and I'd written the majority of Auslander while he was away. And I had no idea he was coming back, and if he was up for, you know, sort of starting Brain Ape again. And Auslander kind of happened really quickly for us after a year of doing absolutely nothing. And then Auslander's taken over my life, so I stopped acting. But my point was, is at that point when Soul left, I changed profession. And although acting and being a musician, there are very, very strong similarities in lifestyle, it's still a massive shift for me at the time, because, you know, everyone was like, you act? And I was like, I didn't even know I acted, you know. Like, it just kind of happened. And they were like, what about music? I was like, I don't know, I'm not doing any at the moment. And then acting stopped as quickly as it had sort of started. So you've no idea what's going to happen. And, you know, in the acting stuff, I was very, very close to signing a massive contract with someone I can't name particularly, a huge studio. And the contract was for 12 years, 6 films. Like, it was going to be and it would have changed my life. Like, there was loads of money involved. And it fell through the last second. And I was like, you know, I thought I'd sorted my life out. And then Soul came back and we did Auslander. Like, you've no idea what's going to happen. You've no idea what's going to happen. So you're winging it the whole time. So I don't think by 30 I'm going to have a clue.